Good morning, I'm Tom Ronan. I'm a Director of Regional Product Line Manager at VIAVI Solutions. I'm joined this morning with Malcolm Campbell. Malcolm is the Senior Manager for Fibre Innovation at Openreach in the Chief Engineering Office. Morning, Malcolm. Thanks
morning,
for joining
Tom.
Us this glorious morning.
Yes, lovely today.
Malcolm, can you talk to us a bit about what you do here at 4 Acre site, please?
Yeah, so 4 Acre is the Chief Engineer's physical infrastructure test and development centre. Chief Engineer is responsible for setting the network architecture, the accreditation, the policy, and we own a lot of the components that you see which are in the network.
We've heard a lot about the impressive scale of deployment that Openreach plans to deliver a network nationally. Can you talk a bit about what goes into testing that infrastructure pre-deployment and post-deployment and what is required to qualify that infrastructure?
Yeah, so as you know, fibre suppliers, they diligently test their products prior to shipping. Once we get them, what we've got to do is the conformance testing and also critically to make sure that they're fit for the network. So that's the health and safety remit. Because of the pace of build, it's important that when we put products in the network, we can rapidly test and qualify those fibres and products as fit for purpose, so they're ready for service. Traditionally, we would do that using an OTDR, bidirectional measurements, or a light source and power meter. Openreach is now looking at using what's known as the optical test head. That sits in a centralised exchange, and it allows us to test out to a reflector at the pole top, the last point of connect for the customer. And that gives us the confirmation that the network has actually been built properly to policy.
I'd like to thank you for partnering with VIAVI in our centralised test head technology. We're delighted to be part of that programme and part of your fibre delivery nationally. I guess from a deployment perspective, there's lots of different environmental challenges, right? So whether you're deploying a network in an urban environment, whether you're going rural environment, and then obviously other considerations like the environmental impact, like flooding and other storms and risks that create issues with the infrastructure, whether you're deploying it underground or overground. Can you talk a bit about how you try to mitigate here against ensuring that you have as low risk as possible in that infrastructure?
We're here on a lovely sunny day today, but we've had extreme weather over the recent years. You know, we've seen a lot of flooding, harsher winters, stronger winds. And when you look at our network, it's built during all those types of environmental effects. When we look specifically at our network, the underground network, it's relatively benign. We've got joint enclosures, which will do sort of 3 meters of water in terms of a head of water for submersion. But when we look then at new cabling techniques and new cable products, we're looking at 864 fibres or more. We're looking at thinner sheaths on cables, and that's duct congestion means that we've got to have a more robust product, and that can contribute to the installation criteria. When we look at the aerial network, we've got ice and wind loading, which can induce strain. Wind can also induce vibration effects, and we see cables, the term is galloping, where the cables will bounce. And then we've got just general strain effects coming into those cables due to tree rub. You might not think about it, but a lot of our network is about 60% overhead. That's a lot of environmental effects and nature, which is interacting with our cabling.
And of course, we cannot stop nature. You mentioned about strain effects. Can you talk a bit about how strain can impact the fibre itself?
When we look at a cable and we look at its installed criteria, if we take the overhead network, for example, what you've got there is you've got clamps holding the cable onto the poles, and that's a pinch point potentially. But then the length of the cable would be subjected to wind and ice and the tree rub. Those can create either small artifacts of strain or tension. So you have forces acting on the fibre, which could be compressive, or they could be tensile forces. Those effects could in turn cause the product to prematurely age. So we're looking to see, does the installation criteria and the criteria we're bound by for things like health and safety, do those play a negative effect? And if so, we need to redesign. So we spend a lot of time qualifying product and redesigning product with our suppliers to meet the very stringent criteria.
We're delighted and proud to be part one of those suppliers that you are using our technology, using our beryllium OTDR, BOTDR, to study the impact of strain on those fibres. Can you talk a bit about how beryllium OTDR, or BOTDR, helps as opposed to a traditional OTDR for measuring those fibres?
Yeah, so a traditional OTDR allows our design engineers to basically measure loss or attenuation across the network. But what it doesn't do is it doesn't allow you to see how that cable is actually interacting over long term. You might not be aware, but the fibre that we put into customers' premises and people's homes, that fibre is what we call a bend insensitive fibre. So it's there that it provides a good link quality in terms of the optical performance. It's quite critical that we look at that to understand how does it affect the mechanical performance. So will it have a lesser life or a shorter lifespan because of the forces employed in bending it around skirting boards and door frames?
Openreach are going to be deploying this network, and hopefully it'll be out there for 30 years. Obviously, keeping that at the highest performance, and highest quality will help in reducing operations and maintenance long term. How much does strain impact aging of that network?
So, Tom, only the other day I was talking to some industry colleagues about 50 and 100 year lifetimes on fibre. Our technology has come on such a long way, you know, since the 1980s when we first started looking at fibre deployment. Fibre is much more robust now. It's faster. It doesn't suffer the effects of electromagnetics that you get on copper, and it's actually quite cheap to run in terms of the optics and things that go on it. And it gives us this unlimited bandwidth. When we look at the fibre performance and we say how does it affect the strain effects, it's more in our case the mechanics of the glass in the installation. So we know that bend insensitive fibres mean we can cope with a harsh environment and we can get optical transmission. But the thing that worries us is the lifetime, the reliability. And we spend a lot of time here, you know, at 4Acre and with our suppliers investigating how we can make the products more reliable. We're looking at to ensure that we've got the correct health and safety requirements around those products, you know, because it's very important that our engineers and our customers who interact with our network are safe.
What do we need to consider more as an industry or VIAVI as a supplier to help operators like Openreach ensure that infrastructure is ready for next generation technologies?
It's education, Tom. We're moving at pace. You know, we're building faster than ever before nationally. To do that and to build at pace, we've got to educate our customers and our engineers. Openreach is set up so that we're doing agile tribes, which is merging IT and engineering together in an iterative cycle so that we can reduce the timescales it takes to launch a new product. So previously we would take months, maybe years to design and develop. Now we're doing it in a space of weeks. And really the key to this is bringing people on board, ensuring that our customers, our partners, and our engineers understand these products. So really for me, it's all about the education as to how we can tell people about what it is we're building and the benefits it will bring.
I'd like to thank you and your teams for continuing to innovate, to look at ways that we can accelerate getting those networks out there to serve more customers and more applications, and continue the good work. Thank you for your time this morning.
Thank you, Tom.